Hi there, and welcome back to the Horde of the Black Sheep, under our new Sultan Hasan Ali Karakoyundu, who is a total genius at administration and who can do absolutely nothing else. But he's well connected. He knows everyone, and so he gets a reduction of advisor costs of 20%. So we went all there and hired 3 advisors. Even though we have to repay some loans still. So what we're doing at the moment is, well, developing. That is what we should do. Oh, Haza, yeah, the military coalition against us after our conquering spree is now dissolving again, which is quite good. We can build a marketplace, and we should do that. Let's look at Baghdad. Baghdad is a great trade province with an immense trade power, and we should definitely build a marketplace there. That's a no-brainer, if you want so. And then we're of course waiting for the bank loan to be repaid. Also Tabriz, we'll build a marketplace there as well. Also very good trade power. In time though. First, we want to be safe with a loan. Let's make it a little slower. Because we need to control all the rebel factions and don't want to miss anything here. As you can see, our merchants are doing good stuff here in Hormuz and in Basra. So golden times are coming. Even though Sultan Hasan Ali isn't, like, the best out there. But his father went on a conquering spree. Took all of this and a little bit of this. And we are now stabilizing. We are improving relations with Muscovy. At the moment, we have a quest for that. And it would also be a good ally because... the number of allies here is limited. We have Akkoyunlu, who hate us. We have the Ottomans, who are hostile. And we have Ramazan, which is Sunni and also don't really like us. And we have the Mamluks, which like us because we improved relations with them. But we still have the aggressive expansion modifier. So we have disloyal estates too, but that will go away. We don't need it at the moment. So it's okay. We have mothballed everything to just to save some money. And we definitely want a fortress in Baghdad, but it's maybe we don't want one in Qazvin, even though it is on the border. So we might keep it for now. So we have some claims. Now note that we're role-playing this, so Sultan Hasan Ali is probably not the one to lead wars or to put claims on people. We have to find another use of Jahan Shah Nasr. Maybe let's look at our rivals and our enemies and see where we can do some counter-espionage. So our enemies, the Great Horde, Akkoyunlu and Georgia. Seriously, who takes Georgia seriously? They're not... I mean, we took them at arrival, but... yeah. So we could send one here for counter-espionage. It's the Great Horde. They're surely spying on us, and... Hasan Ali is... has a sound political instinct, or at least his advisors tell him, right? He's well connected, so yeah. Now they want Astara now, the Great Horde. Really? Oh my god. Timurids no longer a valid rival. What has happened to the Timurids? Are they dead now? Georgia declared war on the Krim. Look at that, the Timurids. And Khorasan has grown. How strange. Khorasan of all things. They are outraged towards us. Well, of course, we're an enemy here. So we need a new rival. What could that be? We have Ark Koyunlu. There they are again. That's absolutely nice. So Ark Koyunlu it is. They hate us, we hate them. They are the white, called the white sheep. They are our bad brother. So totally the right topic here. Improving relations to do that quest. And also because we think that Muscovy would be a good ally. Also note, when you're in the stream in about 10 minutes, I'm going to make a short pause where we can discuss the game and see what we'll do next. Well, I think I want to repay the loan just to have it away and to calculate better, so it isn't left hanging there all the time. It's probably bad play, but yeah. Oh, Khorasan declared war against Ajam. They cite reconquest. I mean, this is one of the moments where we should declare war, but we're role-playing this, and this guy is not going to declare war on anyone. He will look at the defense, he will build some marketplaces maybe, he will build things. He's going to be the builder and developer, and that's also good. Poor vintage we have. One of our prestigious vineyards has shockingly produced a wine of vastly inferior quality. Oh no. Needless to say, people think less of our country for it. I hope I never drank any. Well, our watchers of the faith here, our religious guys are happy that the wine doesn't taste well. And it's harder to convert people with bad wine, apparently, as it moves us towards legalism. So no more making them drunk. That is over. Let's save up a little bit. Look at that. Wow, we're gaining a lot now. 6.8, but we need a lot too. For times of war, that will be gone very quickly. So yeah, we have 3 out of 4 diplomatic relations. That's because we are waiting on Muscovia. Like, if we reach... Sometimes they hate us. Somehow they hate us, so that's not going to work. We're going to have to look for another ally. A big ally would be good. Haza, they hate us because of aggressive expansion and the religion, so probably not. The Timurids, they just hate us. Shamar? They're a tribal federation. Hormuz, they already have too many. Too many relationships. And what is Sistan? Afghanistan, Baluchistan. They're all Sunni. It's terrible. We need more allies. Nogai. Everyone hates us. Yeah, that seems to be our fate. So we must defend well. Even our own people hate us. The Amirs hate us. Well, they are military, so our Sultan doesn't think much of the military, so yeah. Now, the rival for our rival. At least we've gained some diplomatic power now, and what to do now? What would be something he would do? Probably accumulate money. Like someone who can only administrate and is very incompetent from the values. You would probably say, hey, let's collect money. That is very important. And it can be. Let's do that. Let's accumulate money. And we just have an idea. Let's try to milk the estates. We could demand administrative support from the ulema. And make a generous donation to them then. So we're back at the national tax modifier, and then we have the Dhimmi. We could impose a new religious tax for now. They would decrease their loyalty a bit, but they are not that important anyways, right? Dhimmi. Who cares for that religious stuff when you have a good administration that is rich? And then we have our merchant guilds. We could ask for a contribution here as well, decreasing 10 loyalty. Wouldn't be too bad. Wouldn't be too bad. There we go. We could give them a diet. That would increase their influence so much. And that isn't very much liked by our good sultan. So, hey, we're standing there at improve. Oh, has been improved by 90 only? Okay. We can improve it to full 100. Why not? Let's try to find another ally while doing that. Kirkasia seems to be somehow, they are orthodox and they are small, but they're better than nothing. And we're no longer a great power. Well, that was to be expected. And we have Sufi syncretism. What does that mean? Sufis, with a mystical and less legalistic approach to Islam, are often more welcome among the heathen than the highly educated ulema, or soldiers of the faith, manifesting piety in other ways such as dance, singing, and by blending the Islamic traditions with local ones. The Sufis are not always the best term with the religious establishment. A Sufi leader has managed to get quite a following in Van, which we have just converted, or no, which we are just converting, with a great number of Coptic converts joining his disciples. Oh my god. He's doing trouble, right? I mean, we're more on the side of legalism. As a boring administrator, we would probably prefer these bonuses too. To these bonuses. Morale of armies, fort defense, who needs that, right? We need national tax modifier. His followers are clearing land for new settlements where they might live together, and this could well lead to a much greater Islamic influence in the entire area. Many among the ulema are asking that we send him on his way, as they fear he's leading the true faithful astray and blurring the line between Islam and the Coptic faith. The ulema would lose even more loyalty. That means trouble. Or they would gain loyalty, but we would move towards legalism. Ah, that's terrible. Minus five strength. Religious orthodoxy enforced in Kurdistan. Oh, he's doing God's work. Ah, that's terrible. We were so close. And the whole Kurdistan area gets influential Sufi. So the problem is, I think that is, with the role play of this, is that we don't have the right religion there already. So that is not our state religion. So if you would count it right, it wouldn't be religious orthodoxy to let them keep their religion. Ha ha ha. For how long is this going on? How much will that... Total missionary strength is 1.7%. So that would kill us quite for it. In Van. So Van is here. I mean, we could try to wait until we have the Shia face. How long will that be? No, that's nearly a year. That's too long. We have to decide right now. How is the Kurdistan area in general? So that is Armenian. Has a lot of unrest. So Bitlis is okay. That's already our faith. Total screw up of our plans for that. I think he wants, I mean it's one of his goals to get the religious unity up, because he's such an administrator, and that is contrary to his goal. But if the Ulema also lose 10 loyalty, what will we have to do then? Probably seek the support of the clergy. We have done that already. So yeah, screw this. I mean, he's... What will we do? What, I mean, we should look to our advisors. What do our advisors say? They are not of the religious bunch. That is for sure. They're Shiites or Sunni, but they are not, like, if we would have a missionary here, we would go for, he will have to do his preaching elsewhere, but we want to get to the religious unity, so he's doing God's work. If we convert, we'll move towards towards legalism anyways, so that will be much better for us in the long run. So yeah, that was a tough decision to make. We had to resort to our advisors. I mean, we could ask our wife, but she's probably bubbling something. An AI ruler with bubbling buffoon would insult you at random times. I really like that, because we had one here of Mushasha or something, and they insulted us at random times, and I thought, hey, are they going to attack? No, they probably had a babbling buffoon. Are there any real-world examples of babbling buffoon politicians? I don't know. Do you know? let's see. We'll go for the next episode, for the next decisions. Our next things to tackle are disloyal estates. We'll see each other in the next episode. And if you're on the stream, it will continue shortly. We're going for the pause and some discussion. So, for the people watching normally, have a good time until then, dear friends and thinkers. And till the next episode, may the Hall of the Black Sheep be with you.